Welcome to Cessna Home Cockpit. As you can see, I have still the camera mounted on my head, so you can see what I see, or a part of what I can see. And as you notice, probably, I've installed the Garmin G530 and 430 combination. And this is my first flight. I haven't tested it yet. Also, the iPads are not installed right now, so I only have those 8 gauges over here. But we'll see if it works and if the Garmin works. That's the purpose. So let's fire her up. Master switch on. Battery on. Fuel pump on. Let's prime the engine. Fuel pump off and start. So she starts. Let's see the beacon on, and now the test if the avionics work. Avionics master switch on, and as you can see, the Garmin lights up. Let's see if the buttons work. Frequency works. And as you can see, when I switch from COM1 to COM2, switch between VLOG and GPS. The corresponding gauges work. As a matter of fact, this one works. Let's see if this one works. Switch to COM2. Yes, this works. So everything seems to be working fine. I don't know the frequencies of this airport. Well, we can check this out. We are at the PA Victor Delta. This, that's Papa Alpha Victor Delta. And if I'm correct, I don't have the frequency right here, so we can't check our pilot to ATC. We're just running at the background. As you can see, I have to figure a way out to mount this the stack better. I also have to add the textures to the buttons. I know for example that this is the distance, but just better if it's the text is on the buttons. I also have to install two buttons here. And I'm not familiar with the 430, so I'll have to find out how I can work with both radios. But the main purpose for me was to be able to switch between COM1 and COM2, or I mean to use COM2, which was in COM and NAV2, which was not possible when only using the Garmin 530. And with the Garmin 530, you can use COM1, and you can use the NAV1 and NAV2 and come to are on the 430. That's why I installed this. Not all buttons are genuine, those two buttons here and those two are not the real buttons I use, but which I use in the real Garmin, but I use them to make easier for me to operate the buttons. And it's also a matter of money. The buttons are very expensive, so those rotary encoders, double rotary encoders with push button, are about 20 euros per piece. So I only have two of them, those two, and I have to save some money to buy the other two. At the moment, those are also connected to rotary encoders. As you can see, this is for the numbers before the decimal, so I can change now V2. If I switch to this, then you get the frequency, and this is the decimal numbers. Now I've enabled COM NAV2. When I switch on this button, I switch to COM2, from NAV2 to COM2. And also here I can adjust numbers, and this button is for the numbers before the decimal. And so I can activate it. Same goes for this one, and the GPS also works. Perhaps a short flight. Flight. We are at Papa Alpha Vector Delta. So I've still troubles using the rudder pedals. That's something I will do when I am start building the center console with the trim wheel. I will then adjust the rudder pedals so that they are connected to the Arduino board, which gives far better control over the default Cytec hardware. Let's see if I can make a sharp turn. Scenery. So I think it's a nice addition to the cockpit, the G430 in combination with the 530 makes it possible to really navigate, and I only have to learn how to do it, but we'll shoot another video if I figured out how to use the radios properly. Flaps down. A little bit throttle to compensate. For the control. Turn to final. We are back. Way too fast. The purpose of the video was just checking out the radios. In real life I would get fired for this kind of action, I think. See if we can still manage to land this. Way too fast. I should abort the landing, but I have an appointment. I have to visit my daughter. So let's see if I can make it on the ground. So sorry about the landing, but real life has come between me and the hobby, so I have to go. Well, the purpose is to show you the navigation, the radio, and I think that was this went well. So see you next time. Bye bye, and thank you for watching.